Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will see how to customize the date-time axis of Sync Fusion React charts. I will also show you how to add a title, custom range, custom intervals, custom label format, padding range, and nonlinear interval value to the date-time axis in React charts. Let's jump into the code part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Sync Fusion React charts package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic chart rendering code. If you need to learn how to create a basic React chart, you can refer to my Getting Started video linked in the card above or in the description below. With this chart code, you can visualize weather statistics for specific years. Let's take a quick look at the data that I have bound to the data source property of the chart. Notice here, the x-axis in the JSON object contains dates. So I need to configure the chart's horizontal axis with the datetime type. In the app.tsx page, I import the datetime module from the Sync Fusion React chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then I include the primary x-axis property in the chart component tag and set the value type option to datetime. Look at the chart now. The data is plotted as a line series. The date values are displayed on the x-axis. Notice here, the date label is displayed in MMM format. That's because the data source values have common years and days with only differences in months. Let's see how to customize the date format displayed on the x-axis. I have the label format option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to the custom month format. This format displays the full month name. Look at the output. Date labels in the x-axis are displayed based on the specified custom month format. Here, the last date label in the x-axis is partially visible due to its SVG element width. I can solve this by adding the edge label placement property and setting its value to shift. Now, the x-axis label is adjusted to be properly visible. Notice here, the dates in the x-axis range from April to October based on the chart data. What if I want to show a custom period on the x-axis? I can do that by setting a minimum and maximum range in the primary x-axis property. I set a minimum date value of June and a maximum date value of December. See here, the date labels in the x-axis are displayed based on the specified range. I can also customize the interval of labels displayed on the date-time axis. By default, the label interval is 1. Now I include the interval option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to 2. Check now, the x-axis interval is changed based on the provided input. Next, I will show you how to set the range padding in the date-time axis. Using range padding options, you can avoid the partial appearance of data points and labels near the left and right edges of the chart area. The available padding types are none, normal, additional, and round. By default, the range padding is set to auto. The date-time axis does not support normal range padding. Auto behavior will choose any one padding from these three. Here, none padding is applied. To explain this feature clearer, I will comment out a few of the properties I have used before. Let me add the range padding option to the primary x-axis property and set its value to additional. Check the chart. The data points near the left and right edges appear without getting cut off. Now, I change the range padding value to round. See here, the axis range value is rounded to its nearest possible value. Next, I will show you how to display just business days in the date-time axis. To display date-time values with non-linear intervals, I use the date-time category value type. I import the datetime category module from the Sync Fusion React chart package and inject it into the chart services. Then, in the primary x-axis property, change the value type option to datetime category. I'm going to change the data source so that this feature can be clearly understood. I open the data.js file. I have already defined the sales comparison data with the date and value fields. Let me use this sales data in my chart. On the app.tsx page, I import the sales data and use it in the data source property. I set the label format value to a custom date format. Then I add the title option to the x-axis and set its value as business days. I also add a title to the chart as sales comparison. Look, the chart displays only business days on the date time axis. Custom format and title are applied to the date time category axis. Finally, I will show you how to set interval types in the date time category axis. Look here, the chart date time ranges are displayed with a day type. Let me add the interval type property and show you the available types: auto, days, hours, minutes, months, seconds, and years. To view the sales report every month, I set the interval type property value to month. See, the chart date range axis labels are displayed based on the month. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen. We saw how to customize the date time axis of Sync Fusion charts in a React application, and how to set a title, custom range, custom intervals, custom label format, padding range, and nonlinear interval value to the chart's date time axis. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.